Go up, top down, I've been racing. Go up, she wild, I'm in dangerous. Go up, my crowd in rotation, yeah.
Are you on 10 yet? Are you on 10 yet? Wait, are you on 10 yet? Are you on 10 yet?
I live on 10.
Wait, are you on 10 yet? Are you on 10 yet?
Hold up.
Fuck the...
Hey, what's up, kings and queens? It's Theo.
And it's you could tell he's turning on.
Sucks, my bad.
Face all screenshot, trying to mess my hair.
Well, anyways, y'all, man, we about to react to Louis C.K. He doing the N-word. My thing is, we did a reaction to Bill Burr's the N-word. Now, I don't know if Louis C.K. is going to be better than Bill Burr's.
Yeah, I'm curious.
Yeah, but that's my question. I want y'all to let us know what y'all think after the video and everything. I know Louis C.K. is a comedy legend and everything, but I think Bill Burr might be funnier.
Well, let's see. Go ahead.
Everybody has different words that offend them, different things that they hear that they get offended by. To me, the thing that offends me the most is every time that I hear the N-word. Not nigger, by the way. I mean the N-word.
Literally, a white man
with nice hair says the N-word. That's just white people getting away with saying nigger. That's all that is.
As he's saying nigger the whole time.
It's bullshit, because when you say the N-word, you put the word nigger in the listener's head. That's what saying a word is. You say the N-word, and I go, oh, she means nigger. You're making me say it in my head. What are you fucking saying instead? Take responsibility.
I know. Okay, you gotta be funny if you say it, though. That's the thing. That's the problem.
Just say it. Don't hide behind the first letter like a faggot. Just... Hey, nigger, you stupid cunt. I don't care.
Oh, man.
Somebody will kick my ass. I mean, all this shit goes on in my head. I don't really... I thought the word nigger the other day. I'm going to tell you this story. And it wasn't racist. It wasn't a race even connotation. Let me tell you what happened. I went to a coffee place. And it was a cool indie coffee. I don't like Starbucks anymore, because you go there and they don't care anymore. They just press a button and some old lady's diarrhea comes out and they just give it to you. So I go to a young people cool coffee place with my band's playing notices on the walls, and it's called the howling dude whatever thing, and the dude behind the counter's got a tight t-shirt and a ponytail, and he's like, hey, what's up, man? And I was like, hey, can I get a cappuccino? And he's like, yeah, right on, generally. He's amazed that he could help me.
I'm trying to warm back up.
And so he starts making my coffee just so, he works so hard. He ground the beans just for that one cup and put them in the thing and tamped them with this old thing, and he click, clack, and click, and then he took the milk and he frothed it for an hour. And then he banged it on the counter. I don't know why, it was awesome. And he scooped it in and put a little cocoa on it. And he's like, here you go, man. And I was just blown away. And for some reason, as I left there, the thought in my head was, that nigger made the shit out of my coffee. I don't know why. He wasn't black. That's just what was in my heart for some reason. Was that nigger made the shit out of my coffee. I don't know.
Y'all.
I know, right?
What? What? No.
Before y'all think, here it is. Before y'all be commenting just because he's white, and y'all getting offended. First of all, I ain't offended. Okay, so, and second of all, it ain't because he's white. Here's my thing. If you're going to use the word, and you're being a comedian, because here's my thing. If you're a comedian, you're supposed to make different,
you're supposed to make uncomfortable situations.
Funny. It's stuff like that. But if you're doing that, you got to be funny. And, maybe he's funny towards, the other crowd or whatever. But he was just dry. Dry humor.
And I kind of was I don't know. He could have just did a whole lot better. Because really, with that story, you really gonna... I can't imagine him actually thinking that when he's walking out of the store.
My main thing. So basically, I mean, it ain't I don't get the joke. The joke is he's saying nigga, and just from him saying nigga, all the white people think it's funny because he's saying nigga. He ain't supposed to be saying nigga. He's supposed to be saying the N-word and all that stuff. But the thing is, it's just funny because I guess y'all want to say it. Because it's like, I don't know, because you just got to be funny when you say it. Mm-hmm. That's all we trying to get across. Because,
like, this is totally different than how Bill Burr's was. Like, totally yeah. different. Like, I don't know. Yeah. Maybe I got to see other content of his.
For Louis C.K.
Maybe,
stuff.
Yeah. Maybe, I don't know. But I mean, this was a miss for me, you know?
Yeah. I ain't trying to bash him, but, like... you could tell, like, it was some of the dry humor, you know, he tried to do the jacking off thing. Mm-hmm. And I'm trying to, I ain't trying to bash, but wasn't he the one that's trying to, like, you know, doing the jacking off shit with, in front of the women? We were, like, around the same time with the Harvey Weinstein shit. Well, you know, Harvey Weinstein been doing this shit and all this stuff, but he got put out around the same time. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. Excuse me. But, I don't know, man. It's just like, I'm talking about, like, when he did that, that's all I can think of real quick. Because I feel like that was the same dude. Like, I don't know.
I guess, but if y'all know, comment down below and let us know.
It just wasn't there. It wasn't funny. I tried to make it better. I tried to, like, make myself laugh, but it just wasn't working. It wasn't. It's terrible. It's terrible. And, like, it's not even funny terrible. It was trash.
Yeah.
I see you guys later.
maybe it was more to this clip than what we saw.
Pick somebody better. Like,
oh, no, don't say that.
No, I'm saying pick a better, like no.
Pick, y'all recommend something that you think that we'll be, like, really amused by that he's, like, created. Because maybe this wasn't a good one for us to watch. Maybe that's what I'm taking from it.
The ninth time again, we don't care that he, well, I don't care that he's using the N-word. It's just, you gotta be hilarious when you say it, or at least funny. And he was just dry as shit. And that seemed like some 1993 humor. Let's see you guys later.
Bye, y'all.
Peace. Yeah, okay, I'm done.
It's crazy, y'all.
I'm dry as hell.
Action also asked if, for $1 million, would I stay with you if your dick was decapitated?
I don't even know if I could stay alive.
I don't know if I could stay with you.
I can't even imagine life without a dick.
Yeah, neither. I can't imagine you without that.
Sound like that's the only reason you with me.
No, but it's like $1 million or leave you, and you know. So I had to take that clean million.
Yeah.
Can you stop it? You don't even give me a chance to try and get the bar. I realize, I know, but damn, Theo.
You alright, baby?
No, and I'm tired of playing this fucking game. Like, you, like, can we please, can you take the sacrifice and drink the shit? It's ranch and whatever else.
Your booty's it.
Okay, and I've had to drink it 3 times. Seriously, all right, Theo, baby. Come on.
Behind the scenes.